Rogers than Gilmore Girls. And I also have the Cinnamon Bun bookstore. Like, what? Are you kidding me? These books literally scream cozy fall vibes, and I could not be more here for them, actually. So, yeah, very exciting. There's also, she also has the Christmas Tree Farm coming out, which I've already pre-ordered, and there's one other one as well, I forget, but I pre-ordered that as well, but these two are out, and these actually have not been in a haul, so we will read the backs of these. There's actually not that much. It's the season to fall in love. So I got this off Amazon, and like,
crushing on for months.
who's pretending to be a witch. She thinks no one will take it seriously. Wait, so she is a witch. Then she makes, I don't remember reading this, or like the back of this. So she's a witch who pretends to be a witch because she thinks people will think she's pretending. I think is what I got out of that. Okay, but someone does see through it, I guess. Huh. Oh, and then she goes to this mysterious house, the Nowhere House, to teach witches how to control their magic. Cute. She has tangled up in their lives. Blah, blah, blah. Okay. That sounds cute. I like it. Okay. I actually just remembered a couple other books, recent purchases I have on my shelf. Maybe I'll sneak those in at the end. But next is another romance, but with a twist. So I have Bride. Bride by Allie Hazelwood. I love Allie Hazelwood. She is a well-known romance writer. text messages. But it just seems like it's so cool. I love when books have like this kind of stuff in them. Yeah, texts and things. So cool.
To
recent video on like a come book shopping with me. So I very recently read the backs of these, but all of the books that I got in that video screamed like this time of year to me, and I could have had them all in this video, but I didn't want to have them all again, so I pulled two of them. That is Masters of Death by Olivia Blake. Gorgeous freaking copy. As well as House of Hollow. Another gorgeous copy. So this one, struggling a real estate agent. It's giving like kind of dark academia vibes. They're trying to sell a haunted house, but there's this ghost that was murdered in the house and is haunting the house, so they have to try to figure out like who killed this ghost, kind of help the ghost run away. She's a real estate agent and a vampire. They're not separate, they're the same person. And there's a medium named Fox Demora, so I'm guessing that Fox helps to sort out this ghost dilemma. But the vibes just seem so good, so perfect in this. It says there is a game that the immortals play. There's only one rule: don't lose. Came out, but it's been, I've seen a few people talking about it. Yeah, 2018, but I feel like it's kind of either made a resurface or it's just getting like really popular right now. But yeah, I feel like I've never read an Olivia Blake novel, but seems like their vibe is very like dark academia. Oh no, their hair is now white. It was dark. Just like weird. is cursed to never find true love, but when she meets a young woman who doesn't believe in magic, she dares to hope for more. Again, beautiful, beautiful vibes. And then the spell shop. She'd